Now, as long as the number of electrons exchanged was the same, you did not have any trouble. So this was Zn2 plus, this is Cu2 plus, and this was 0.059 upon 2. This is the number of electrons. Now what happens in a nickel silver, electrode? Okay. Now, if you recall, I'm talking about nickel silver electrodes. Okay. Now if we go back to the standard electric potentials, the potentials, then we find that nickel gets reduced. Okay, nickel gets reduced, and what is the reduction potential? Ni2 plus plus 2 electrons giving us Ni, and the electrode potential, standard reduction potential, is minus 0.25 volts. Okay, silver, the silver is a monovalent atom, and this has a reduction potential of 0.80 volt, right? It is 0.80 volt. So which gets reduced and which gets oxidized? It is actually the silver which has to get reduced, because its reduction potential is more, and this will get oxidized. So how do I form the cell? The cell is like this: Ni2 plus, Ag plus, Ag. Now there is a trouble here. What is the trouble? The trouble is that the number of electrons exchanged is not the same. Okay, they are not the same. So let us come to this. So let us write the reduction potential of both. So this is how it will look like, right? The reduction equation will look like this. Now from the Nernst equation, what do we get? We get that Ni 2 plus slash Ni is equal to E naught Ni 2 plus slash Ni minus RT upon 2F. RT upon 2F. RT upon 2F into LN. LN is 1 upon concentration of Ni 2 plus. Okay, Ni 2 plus. Similarly, you write the equation for this. So it is E Ag plus slash Ag is E naught Ag plus slash Ag minus RT upon, there is only one electron exchange, upon F LN 1, since the concentration of silver is 1, upon Ag plus. Okay. Now you should understand that while subtracting, I want to take out this common. Okay, I want to take out this common. So I want a 2 to be here. Okay, I want a 2 to be here. So let me write it in the next step. So it is EAG plus slash AG, okay, minus RT upon F. What I do, I multiply and divide by, so 2 and 2, okay, 2 ln 1 upon AG plus whole square. Right, now what happens? it is E right minus E left, right? So E cell is equal to E Ag plus slash Ag minus E Ni 2 plus slash Ni, because these are subtractions of reduction potential. So that gives me this minus this, okay? So it will give me Ag plus slash Ag minus RT upon 2F into this 2 was not there, I've erased it. Okay, so RT upon 2F and A log B, that's another A log B, can be written as log B square. I can do away with the parentheses. Log B square, log B to the power A, okay? A log B can be written as log B to the power A. So I have this, understand? What can I write it like? Log 1 upon Ag plus whole square. So I write this minus RT upon 2F ln 1 upon 1 squared A upon B whole square is A upon B whole square is A square upon B square. So 1 upon Ag plus square is 1 square upon this square, and that is this, okay? Minus, I have E Ni 2 plus slash Ni minus RT upon 2F ln 1 upon Ni 2 plus. And if we want to work with negatives, so it is E Ag plus slash Ag minus Ni 2 plus slash Ni not minus, this is minus, right? So minus RT upon 2F, I get it as common, okay? Minus I have taken as common, so log 1 upon Ag plus square minus 1 upon this, right? Okay, now what is that? This makes it E cell standard, right? This is the standard one, minus RT upon 2F ln. This will go up, right? So it is 1 upon Ag plus whole square divided by 1 upon Ni 2 plus, which is equal to E cell naught minus RT upon 2F, okay, Ni 2 plus upon Ag plus whole square. We get that? So E cell, I'll write it here, E cell becomes E naught cell minus RT upon F and that, I'm sorry, this is ln, okay, this is ln. That gives me 0.059 and this 2 remains, okay? Because I know that RT into 2.303 upon F is equal to 0.059. You should keep that in mind, okay? This is something that you should keep in mind. Okay, this ln Ni2 plus upon Ag plus, this becomes log. Okay, so if you have the understanding of log, then these things do not become such a problem, right? They are not such a problem, and it can be readily written. Fine, it can be very readily written if you understand just the Nernst equation and the fundamentals of log. Nothing else is required. So maybe in one of them there is a two electron exchange, in one of them there is three electron exchange. So you just make it RT by 2F or 3F and raise it to whatever power you want to. Okay? Fine.